शंकर हर हर शंकर जय जय शंकर हर हर शंकर जय जय शंकर हर हर शंकर जय जय शंकर हर हर शंकर
जय जय शंकर हर हर शंकर जय जय शंकर हर हर शंकर
हर हर शंकर जय जय शंकर हर हर शंकर जय जय शंकर
जय जय शंकर हर हर शंकर जय जय शंकर
वॉल्यूम 1 पार्ट 9 चैप्टर 16 वर्ड फॉर भक्ति एवरी कॉज हैज एन इफेक्ट ऑल फिजिकल साइंस डील्स विद दिस लॉ द यूनिवर्स फंक्शंस इन ऑर्डरली मैनर बिकॉज ऑफ दिस लॉ इट इज क्लियर दैट बिकॉज देयर इज वन ग्रेट इंटेलिजेंस These laws have appeared and that they are well coordinated and therefore worldly life was born. If in the physical world there is the inevitable chain of cause and effect, in man's life also it must operate, is it not? For all our activities there must be consequences. If we do good acts, we get equally good fruits. If we do bad, we get equally bad in return. The one who gives the fruits in this manner, Phaladata, is the great power which operates the universe. Ishwara, Bhagavan, Swami, Paramatma, Kadavul in Tamil, etc. So long as the mind is there, it will be in a state of agitation. It will think of the bad along with the good. Along with the punya, it will go on committing sins also. As a consequence of these sins, the Lord Bhagavan will keep giving us pain and troubles. Generally, all people do prayers only to get relief from pain and troubles. This they think is bhakti. If the Lord wants, He may not give us pain and troubles in return to our sins, but we do not have the qualification to force Him to remove our problems. This is because He only has given these fruits in return for our karma. Therefore, much better than this could be to pray that even if difficulties come, we should have the mental attitude not to mind them. But even this prayer is not true bhakti. When we place our difficulties before Ishwara, it amounts to our thinking that He does not know it. That is, we try to diminish the omniscience of Ishwara who knows everything. When we pray, remove this difficulty or change the mental attitude which becomes concerned with difficulties, it also means that He does something on our asking. That is why we are diluting His compassion that flows automatically. A prayer which introduces fault in the jnana and compassion of which the Lord is ocean is not true bhakti, but by such prayers the Lord in our mind becomes light at least temporarily and we gain a little peace. We get the humility to give up the ego that we on our own can achieve everything and beseech the Lord. That is too good. He may, ignoring the devolution we did of His jnana and compassion, and even overlooking our karma, respond to our prayer. But in human life, if one difficulty goes, another will come. Therefore, there will be no end to pray to Him for redressal of our worldly day-to-day problems. Bhakti is surrender, saranagati, with the thought, let things happen in the way you have allowed them to happen. If man does not think of anything for himself, the dirt in the mind will go and it will be clear like a mirror. Then we can be in the fullness of happiness with the thought, I do not want anything for myself. If one surrenders to another, maybe anybody, the wife to the husband may be bad, a disciple to the guru may be a spurious one, then there is no worry. Its ultimate fruit will be moksha. But although in the Puranas mention has been made of those who had attained divinity by surrendering to such a husband or such a guru, in practice it is not possible to surrender to someone who has the same faults and shortcomings like ourselves. If we get a guru who is fit for us to surrender and we surrender to him, then there is no need for Swami even. But in practice it is possible for us to surrender only to the Lord of all worlds whose prosperity is everything and pray, everything yours, there is no such as mine. By this we are able to get peace. One more reason for practicing devotion is that there is no happiness if we live without showing love. By experience, we know that the happiness gained by showing love is not found in anything else. But to whomsoever we may show love, one day or the other we get separated from him or her, or he or she leaves us. The love which was full of joy turns into wailing. Ishvara is the only one permanent who will not leave us. If love is turned to him, this love will keep giving happiness permanently. When this love attains perfection, everything will be seen as he only. Instead of showing love towards one and because of that, enmity towards another, since he is everything, let us show love to all without consideration of high and low. Bhakti alone helps us to prevent wasting human birth by living a life devoid of love. By bhakti, we can get rid of our worldly problems step by step, or we can elevate our attitude in such a way that we ignore the problems. We can remove the blemishes of the mind. We can prevent the mind from vacillating and bring it to concentration. We can attain happiness by gaining the never-perishing permanent love over and above everything. It is only if we surrender to the one who gives us the fruits of karma. He will release us who are bound to worldly life and at the end give us mukti or moksha. That is, he will see that we are in the state in which we realize and experience that he only has become me and all other things. This Advaita Jnana, knowledge of non-duality, and mukti we can get by his grace only. These are the many reasons for practicing bhakti.
Shankara Jaya Jaya Shankara Hara Hara Shankara Jaya Jaya Shankara Hara Hara Shankara Jaya Jaya Shankara.